Josh Hutcherson. He's not a perfect actor or a terrible actor, but he sure is an actor. Well, everyone first met him for the Hunger Games series. I first knew him for Sephora. But there was another movie in 2005 that also starred him. And it's a film you probably didn't know existed, and you probably just heard of it now, Little Manhattan. Little Manhattan was a 2005 rom-com movie that starred Josh Hutcherson and Charlie Ray. While it received positive reviews from critics, it had poor marketing, bombed in the box office, and no one ever talked about it again. Hell, no one knows what it is. Want proof?
Hey, does anyone remember Little Manhattan?
No!
Well, excuse me for living!
I watched it a few years back and I thought it was a cute, simple, fun little rom-com. And this is coming from a person who hates rom-coms!
No!
Does this film deserve to be talked about or even remembered? Let's take a look. This is Little Manhattan.
Okay, so you know how earlier when I said that no one's ever heard of this movie at all? Well, apparently there is one person that knows what this movie is. And that person is 20th Century Fox. And they hated the fact that I was reviewing a movie that no one even cared about. So, but regardless, even though no one knows it exists, they gave me a copyright strike either way. In my defense, I figured I wouldn't get copyright strike because no one knows what this movie is, but apparently Fox does. So throughout the rest of the video, I'm going to have to put this filter right here so that way I'll lessen the chances of getting a copyright strike. Believe me, I didn't want to do this either. But if you want to see a filter-free version of this review, go check it out over on my Instagram account, Nerdgeekman Reviews. That's my second Instagram account. The one, Nerdgeekman, is my main account. The Reviews is my second account, just in case any of my future reviews gets taken down by YouTube. So, without further ado, enjoy the rest of this video with the filter. Screw you, Fox.
Back in the day, maybe first or second grade, popular wisdom was, they gave you cooties.
Hey, remember cooties? You know, when once a girl touches you, it means you have some sort of fake germ that will affect you unless you get it with someone else? We were young. We men have matured from that kind of nonsense. Am I right? Right? Right?
If a girl touched you, some very, very bad things were gonna happen.
Who wants chowder?
And here we have our main character, Gabe, played by Josh Hutcherson. He has a great life of good friends and a kicking career. That was until he decided to take karate, where he meets his sparring partner, Rosemary, played by Charlie Ray. Although they're good friends in their class, she suddenly becomes his first love.
Hey! Hey! Stop the music! They're children!
Killjoy.
Gabe goes to visit Rosemary to practice for the next karate class.
Alone with her.
Kia!
Smelling her smell. What is that?
What the hell? Did he just sniff her floor?
So what made you take karate?
Made me? Daryl Kitson's.
Daryl Kitson's made you take karate?
Yeah, have you seen the guy? He's insane. Daryl Kitson's is without a doubt the scariest kid in the Upper West Side.
Oh, the stereotypical bully who's just there to be just a bully without character or reason to be one. How quaint. It's revealed to Gabe that Rosemary is an incredibly busy girl. She has lots of scheduled plans, and a lot of them. It's also revealed that Gabe's parents are divorced, but even though they're divorced, they still care for their son. But regardless, Gabe still has a good life in Manhattan. He rides around and knows all about the city, and ever since he met Rosemary, he's been checking around her apartment ever since. And still waiting for her to come out. And waiting. And waiting. And waiting. And I'm sorry, I don't mean to yell, but Gabe's a freaking creep! Yeah, did you notice earlier that he sniffed the floor while sparring? And now he's clearly stalking her, waiting for her to come out. He's that one Hobbit guy from Smiling Friends. Now you're gonna say, Nerdgeekman, he's a kid. True, but not all of us when we were kids just magically found the address of our crush and went in front of her house to stalk her. Look, I wanna relate to Gabe. I really do. Because I too have problems talking to women. But when you're creepily stalking a girl and following her everywhere, that's completely gross. I wonder how Katniss Everdeen would have reacted if Peeta did this in his childhood. So Gabe shows Rosemary around the park.
See those buildings up there? When I was younger, I used to pretend they were pirate ships and I'd fight them.
I never took you for a pirate guy.
Oh, I outgrew that eventually.
Remember this as the day you almost called Captain Jack. Wait, how the hell did I get up here? Did I drink too much rum again? Gabe and Rosemary agreed to have a day to practice their karate. And here we have my personal favorite character, Ralph. He may be an elevator guy, but he's such a pretty chill guy. If I were in an elevator with him, I'd definitely talk to him a lot because he looks like someone that could give you advice on life. Gabe discovers a show called Extreme Martial Arts, and he practices to prepare for his date.
Mike pioneered XMA, Extreme Martial Arts. He's believed in the fundamentals.
Ow! I think I broke my spleen! Oh, you're just gonna stare at me and not call the hospital? Okay then, some parents you are!
Rosemary arrives at Gabe's house and they begin sparring.
Sparring that day, I was channeling none other than the Great One himself.
Persona! I'm sorry, it was either this or a JoJo reference.
Kiss her! Kiss her!
I can't, that's disgusting!
Oh, but sniffing her floor wasn't? Hey! What part of their children did you not understand?
Alright, jeez, Buzzkill!
Do you... want some Gatorade?
And you are doing so well!
They take a break from sparring and they look for an apartment for Gabe's dad to live in. They agreed to go on another date to look at it.
That your girlfriend?
Excuse me?
She your girl?
Hey, it's that hitchhiker from Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back!
She trampled my heart. Left me bleeding on the floor.
You get a ride, it's expected. I don't care who the driver is. It's the first rule in the book.
Gabe and Rosemary find a small public park to look at and they get cornered by the bully.
Get the hell out of my mouth!
Ah, karate! My only weakness, apparently! Oh, that's it! They're gonna feel my wrath! Crap, they got away! And that's the last time you'll ever see me.
After the date's over, Gabe gets grounded for worrying his parents. He can't afford to miss his next class, so he makes a deal by washing the dishes. He arrives at his karate class to see Rosemary, only for a new kid to take his spot, Tim Staples.
Do you, Rosemary Telesco, take Tim Staples to be your lawfully wedded husband?
Gabe? Your new sparring partner will be David Betanahu.
This is my level? David Betanahu?
David Betanahu, huh? That sounds like a fun name to say. David Betanahu, David Betanahu, David Betanahu, David Betanahu, David Betanahu. Whoa!
Kia!
I had my fun. Rosemary calls Gabe over on another date to a jazz concert.
You like jazz?
Gabe meets her parents and they go see a singer named Lawston Harris. Man, I love jazz appreciation.
It's high above you.
All right, if you play that song one more time, I'm gonna shove a shark up your butt till you call it macaroni.
Wow, angry much?
But honestly, this is the best scene in the movie. The tension, the singing, the hands, the atmosphere. It's such a calm, controlled, and well-made scene. And look at that! They're holding hands! That's so cute! Nothing can ruin this. Wow, Gabe. You just had to screw it up, didn't you? I wonder how this would be played in real life. Gabe arrives early to his class and he sees his rival.
Staples.
Take a close look, because I rule, baby!
And who do you rule? The large dark nipple people?
If only life was so simple.
Rosemary arrives late and looks at Gabe.
She came. She's here. She loves me. Wait a minute. What was that? Was that a smile, or is she, like, mad at me? Why would she be mad at me? I only kissed her.
Yeah, without her consent!
She loves me.
Little punch. Kia!
She loves me not.
Sidekick. Kia!
She loves me.
Understand?
Loves me not.
And I looked at her, and she looked back at me, and I said, I think you have something in your teeth.
Okay, that actually fits the scene. At least it didn't play. Dave takes down David and spots the sensei in order to impress Rosemary again. It's a board! It's not even possible to break your arm that way! Look, I'm no expert in martial arts and all that, but I've seen people breaking boards completely fine. Sure, you'll hurt your hand in the process, but it's clearly impossible for a wooden board to break your arm. What was it made of? Tony Stark scrap suits? So Rosemary calls Gabe to check up on his arm.
So, when can we hang out?
It's a really crazy weekend for me.
It is? It's Thursday night. She's going to camp Sunday morning. Who cares how crazy the weekend is?
Rehearsal dinner tomorrow night. Wedding on Saturday. Camp on Sunday.
Sure. Right, of course. Where's the whole wish you could come to the wedding? Where's that Rosemary? The Rosemary I loved. Not this alien with her crazy weekends.
Gabe? Has it been clear to you that she doesn't want to see you again? After the night you kissed her, she was clearly uncomfortable with you doing that. Think, Gabe. Think. You really thought after you kissed her, she totally loved you? Oh, look. Now you're jealous because you think she's in love with that Ross Lynch lookalike. Oh, and now you're arguing with her to say you hate her because she has busy things to do instead of spending your time with your creepy ass. Oh, and now you're crying because she doesn't want to see you anymore after what you did. You know what? Good. Cry. Cry. Cry some more! You brought this upon yourself, you creepy stalker! Cry knowing that you will never ever see her again because of what you did! You pompous, selfish, perverted, freaking piece of crap! Ah! Huh, that felt good. Sorry about that, guys. While I get to listen on how love is a giant sack of crap, they could have executed a lot better because I've been there. I know what it's like to be in love with someone that doesn't care for you, and I'm glad I moved on from my past crushes because I knew they weren't the right one for me. So while the message was perfectly clear in this scene, it would have been more emotional if it wasn't for the creepy and weird things Gabe did. That's my two cents. So after growing over her and getting his health back, he fully regrets what he said to Rosemary, so he finally gets the opportunity to tell her how he really feels about her just to get some closure.
But I thought you hate me.
I don't. I lied, Rosemary. I love you.
You what?
I do. I'm sorry, but I love you more than anyone has ever loved. I love you, I love you, I love you. You think you might want to love me too?
And it's clear they're both not ready for love yet. So to do one final dance before they say goodbye forever. I'm glad I beat up that music guy because he probably would have ruined this cute moment.
Oh, I can't feel my face.
Walk it off! After the dance, Gabe comes home to see his parents reminiscing about the times they spent together. So they go out to dinner as a family and we get a closing monologue.
Love is an ugly, terrible business. Practiced by fools. It'll trample your heart and leave you bleeding on the floor. And what does it really get you in the end? Nothing but a few incredible memories that you can't ever shake. The truth is, there's gonna be other girls out there. I mean, I hope. But I'm never gonna get another first love. That one's always gonna be her.
10 years later!
Time?
So that was Little Manhattan. It was cute. Despite my problems with it, and they could have done it better without Gabe being a pretentious creep, it really is an underrated movie. The chemistry between Gabe and Rosemary were cute, the acting was good, and the shots in Manhattan are frickin' beautiful. Seeing these amazing shots makes me want to visit Manhattan sometime in the future. While I'm not a big fan of rom-coms, I actually recommend it. Sure, it's not a perfect film, but for what it is, it's a cute story, and I can dig that. Although Gabe's still a little bit of a perv. Uh-oh.
Hey, you lousy woman, rectify this!
He rides around, knows all about the city, and ever since he met Roseburg, he's been checking around her After the dance, Gabe comes home to see his parents reminiscing about the times they spent together. So they go out to dinner and spend. After the dance, Gabe comes home to see.